Hi guys, this is just a short video I've made on the concept of freshwater allowance, and this was asked by a subscriber, and he asked me to explain this concept using some animations. So this concept is about freshwater allowance, also known as FWA, and freshwater allowance is a concept used in ship stability. It is basically the increase in draft when a ship goes from salt water or seawater to freshwater, or the decrease in draft when the ship goes from fresh water to salt water. So when the density decreases from seawater to fresh water, the draft of the ship will increase. And when density increases from fresh water to seawater, the draft of the ship decreases. So for all these purposes, the density of salt water or seawater is considered as 1.025, and the density of fresh water is considered as 1. So let me show you by animations on a ship goes from salt water to fresh water. So in this case, when the ship goes from salt water to fresh water, the density of the water in which the ship is floating is basically decreasing from 1.025 to 1. In this case, because the density is decreasing, the draft of the ship will increase. That means the ship will sink as it goes from salt water to fresh water. This amount of sinkage that happens is known as the freshwater allowance. The same thing happens when a ship from freshwater goes into salt water. The ship will rise, or the draft will decrease, by the same amount as of freshwater allowance. The formula of freshwater allowance is given as displacement divided by 40 TPC, where TPC is nothing but tons per centimeter immersion. So TPC is basically the weight required to sink or rise the ship by 1 centimeter. So if you divide displacement by 40 times TPC, you can calculate the freshwater allowance. Four line marks, if you want to understand this concept, you can see that in salt water, the ship can be maximum loaded up to the salt water load line, that is denoted by S. So the top of the saltwater load line is the maximum up to which a ship can be loaded when the ship is floating in salt water. But when the ship goes from salt water to fresh water, we can keep into mind the freshwater allowance, and we know that the ship will sink further by the amount of freshwater allowance, as I'll show you in the animations here. So when the ship goes from salt water to fresh water, it automatically sinks by the amount known as the freshwater allowance, which can be measured from top of the plimsoll mark. So the plimsoll mark that you see is the circle with a horizontal line crossing between it. So that's the plimsoll mark. So from top of the plimsoll mark to top of the freshwater load line is the freshwater allowance. So knowing these values helps us to calculate how much cargo the ship can load or reject, considering if the ship goes from salt water to fresh water. Alright, so this is an important concept in stability, and some students asked me to make a video on this to understand this concept through animations, and that is why I made this short video, just to explain to you the concept of freshwater allowance. I have used this concept in calculations in my other videos of ship stability. I'll provide you with the links to those videos as well in the description section below. I hope this helped you in understanding the concept of freshwater allowance and what really happens to a ship when we think about it. In similar terms, we also have something called dock water allowance, or DWA, that explores the relationship between seawater and dock water. So dock water can have density of different values. So depending on whether the density is more than seawater or less than seawater, the ship will rise or sink accordingly when the ship goes from salt water to dock water, or vice versa. But this concept is very similar. So to freshwater allowance explores the relationship between salt water and fresh water, whereas dock water explores the relationship between dock water and seawater. Alright guys, if you have any questions regarding this concept, please write in the comment section. I look forward to reading your comments and feedback. I'll see you soon with my next video. Bye guys, and all the best with your studies.